Hi, this is Manny, and I'm here in the ADU garage conversion, and I have an update on issue number 3. So one of the things that happens when you convert an existing structure, like a garage or a patio, into an ADU is that you end up with one or more shared walls between the ADU and the main house or the main structure. So in my case, I have this wall that is shared between the garage and the main house. And in this particular area here in the living room, the wall is pretty much separating the two units. And what I'm being told is that there's different ways to insulate it for sound. And I looked up on YouTube videos and on Google and on Wiki about, there's a lot of different ways that you can use to insulate for noise. And this is what I'm being told that may be enough with the way we're going to be doing it here. So my existing wall has 5/8 of an inch drywall plus 1/4 inch plaster. And so that is giving me 7/8 of material on the existing wall on the other side of the garage. We're going to put R15 insulation, as you can see, it's right there. So these R15 bats are gonna go in between the 16-inch studs, and that's gonna provide additional insulation, not too much. And then per structural support, my plans call for using 5/8 plywood. So they're going to put 5/8 plywood on this wall right here. And then after the 5/8 plywood, or actually maybe he told me it was gonna be thicker than, no, I think it's 5/8, or maybe he said 3/4 plywood. And then on top of that, there's gonna be 5/8 drywall that's required as a fire retardant. So that wall is gonna have a lot of material, and what my general contractor is telling me is that that should be enough to provide a good sound barrier between the two spaces. Also, I purchased these putty pads, and they also have a 49 STC rating and a 2-hour fire rating. And so what these pads are used for, as you can see in the little corner, they're these red pads, and they're made out of putty. They go in the back of the electrical boxes. So these electrical boxes transmit a lot of sound, and there's gonna be more on this side. Where did they go? Oh, they moved them. There's one there that, there's gonna be two more. So all of them have to be protected with that putty pad, so that you insulate it for noise and fire. And so this wall should be fairly well protected as is. And then in the bedroom area, there's also the whole wall, in addition of having all the same materials as the other side, it's also gonna have a closet here with doors. So I get a lot of buffering here in the bedroom. So I think the noise from the bedroom here to the main house is gonna be very minimal, because there's actually a lot of material in between the two places. In the living room, it's just gonna be that one wall. And so I also have a backup plan. If the material that's gonna be added is not enough, they do sell something called Quiet Rock at Lowe's. That one is only 1/4 inch or maybe 1/2 inch thick, and that doesn't meet the fire ratings that are needed to separate the two units. So I may use it afterwards on top of all the material that's there. So I wouldn't take anything down. I would just add additional soundproofing using that drywall called Quiet Rock. And so that I would need about maybe 6 sheets to put in here. Now, the thing about that Quiet Rock sheets is that I looked at the price of a 4x8, and I believe it was 1/2 inch thick. I could be wrong. Maybe it was 1/4 inch. that quiet rock is expensive. It's 4 to 5 times more expensive than regular drywall. So if you can limit to only put it where you need it, and in my case, that is my backup plan. If the amount of material that I have in there doesn't insulate very well, which I'm being told by my general contractor, and I have also looked in Wiki, you know, that should be pretty good, so that if somebody can be over here watching TV, listening and talking to somebody, and that noise wouldn't carry across. And if it's a problem, I could always then add that quiet rock afterwards. And there are websites that show you how to use that. And so that is going to be my plan for suppressing noise going between the two units. And since my son is going to be moving in here, I always have access to the living room to be able to, you know, put additional quiet rock drywall so that it would insulate the sound much better. But we're trying to get ready for inspection, but there's still a lot of work to be done. Most of the electrical is done. It's about 80% done, but they still need to come and finish it. And here's where the laundry room, here's where the sink is going to be, and here's the shower. It's going to be a walk-in shower with a toilet here, and then these are the frames for the pocket doors. There's one pocket door here, a wall separating the sink and the washer and dryer, and here's another pocket door, and then this is going to have a regular door to come in, and this is a bedroom. I think the bedroom is coming out to be a little bit smaller than I thought it was going to be, but with the vaulted ceilings, it's actually going to feel pretty big, and I think I made the right decision in making the bedroom smaller, making the closet big, and also making the living room area a little bit more spacious. So, and then of course the kitchen's gonna be over here. So this is gonna look a lot like my detached unit, but it's gonna be the ADU garage converted. And as you can see, there's a huge beam up there. That's a support beam, and the posts holding it up on both sides. So that's what's happening here. And again, all of the plywood is required on the inside to provide additional structural reinforcement. So I was actually surprised on how much reinforcement is being done in this unit. I mean, I didn't realize they were gonna do so much reinforcement. I mean, it has plywood on the outside and it's gonna have plywood on the inside. So that's a lot of plywood. Unless I'm wrong and the plywood only goes on that wall, because I think all the walls have to have plywood. So maybe that's the part that I don't understand in terms of how much plywood is gonna be in here. So by the amount of plywood that's here, maybe the only thing remaining is this wall. So after they insulate, then we have to bring in the inspector to inspect all of the electrical, the gas line, the water lines, the rough framing, and then move on. But this is taking a long time. I don't think we're going to finish by the end of March, and that was my goal, to finish by the end of March. But, well, progress is being made. It's going a lot slower than I thought it would be going, but we're already basically a month and a half late from what I originally thought it was going to be finished at the end of January. That was my original assessment. Then I thought it was end of February, and then end of March, and at the rate we're going, it's going to be end of April, it seems. But a lot of progress. It doesn't look like a lot, but there's a lot of wood in here. I mean, I'm just shocked to how much wood they've put into this reinforcement of the garage structure. Yeah. So, anyways, that is it. This is issue number 3. And thank you for watching and listening, and and keeping up with all the updates of building a ADU garage conversion. It doesn't go fast, that's for sure.